Hey, Wayne here, and today I have the Thinkware Dashcam to review for you. Okay, so this is the Thinkware Dashcam. It is model number Q800 Pro, two channel. So this camera has two cameras. It's got the main camera right here. Gonna go over things in detail later. This is the rear camera that you can stick pointing out the back of your window. And this is the mounting plate for the main camera. This is the cigarette charger power adapter for the main camera. And this is a hardwire kit if you want to hardwire this into the car. And it came with a second hardwire kit. I'm not exactly sure why yet, but it seems to me that this will plug in, the rear camera will plug into this cable, which will plug into the USB input right here on the main camera, and then main power out to the hardwire. So I'm not sure why there's a second one here. Figure it out and I'll let you know later on in the review. Here's the paperwork on the camera. And here's some cable management stuff. A USB adapter to put into your computer if you want to review the video that is on this micro SD card. I think it's a 32 gigabyte. Yeah, it's a 32 gigabyte SD card. So that's all the parts. I'm going to get into it, install it, and figure it all out, and go over things with you in more detail in just a little bit. Okay, so I quickly wanted to show you how I installed the camera in the car. I have it mounted behind the rearview mirror, and the camera portion of the dash cam is right here, pretty dead center of the hood and the windshield. You can turn this up and down in case the camera's too high or too low. So that's a good place for it. When you look from inside the car, you can hardly see where the dash cam is. So anyway, here are the wires, the power wire and the rear view or the rear camera wire. So it's just going under the headliner here. And this is pretty easy to pull down with your fingers and tuck the wires in. But in case any of your panels are a little tight, a little hard to get in, I'm going to show you some tools that I used in certain parts of the car and where you can get them. So basically though, I ran the wires through the headliner, down the center, the side pillar here, all the way down behind the glove box. Just tuck the wires behind the rubber here and down underneath the glove box. One of the wires, the power wire, is going across and coming all the way around over here to the center console cigarette charger adapter here. So I'm going to probably change this and get an adapter for this that this will plug into another cigarette charger type adapter, and the other end will come out USB because this car has USB in it, so that I can plug straight into that and keep the wires completely hidden because they're down this box here. So I will probably do that later. Another option is to hardwire it into the car. When you do that, you get more options, but I'm not sure I'm going to do that. I may, but I'll show you all the tools and things for that too in case I do it. So continuing on, the other wire is coming under this panel here and going all the way back to the back seat. Coming under this panel here, continuing on and on back under this rubber here, all the way up and around and again into the headliner in the rear of the car. And there's the second camera right there. So works good, nice clean job. And I'm going to show you footage and some stuff on the camera on how to use it and the tools that I use coming up next. So now this is the old cigarette charger AC adapter that I'm going to remove. And this is the new hard wire going in and across the headliner and down the pillar and all the way down to underneath here where I added these two to the new fuse box or to the fuse box, these two new wires to the fuse box. And I grounded it right here
I could have screwed into something like this, but I just screwed it into the side right there. And I used one of these to test for AC power and battery power. And I used these to take the fuse out and add a new fuse, two new fuses in right here. So, and that's it. So pretty easy. It's hardwired into the car now, and the dash cam acknowledges it, and it works great. Okay, so when you first get in the car, if it's hardwired and there have been events like somebody hit your car or pushed your car or something and it felt something, it's going to tell you that there was an event while you were gone. And that's a good idea at that time to go check the footage. If nothing has started, then when you start your car, it should sound pretty much like one of these. It's either going to say there's an event or it's going to tell you that it's connecting. So I put the car in accessory mode right now, as if I had started it. And let's see what it says.
Continuous recording will now start. GPS connected. On your smartphone, connect to a Wi-Fi network whose name starts with Thinkware.
Okay, so what you're going to do there is go to your settings. I'm on an Apple iPhone. I don't know about Android. And you look for Thinkware and you connect to it. I'm sure it's the same. And once you connect to it, you can bring up the Thinkware app and go to connect. Actually, you can just go connect via Wi-Fi. Hit next.
Connected to a smartphone.
And then you can immediately start live view. So the dash cam doesn't have a camera, right? So you can use this. You can, you know, turn it horizontally and get the whole picture bigger. You can tap on it and tap this little R at the top, and now you can see the rear camera. There it is. And of course you can tap and go back to the front camera. Now I'm going to go through some of these menus here and show you what it can do. So dash cam settings. So you have memory card settings, continuous priority, and you can format the card from here, which is probably a good idea if you're going to put another card in. And I'm going to put a note up somewhere on some information I found out about using the different cards. Some work, some not so well, and maybe some not at all. But I'm going to post a little information for you that may help if you're going to change to another SD card and you want to avoid problems. So let's go back, and now for camera settings, I have everything set to bright, and at first I thought it looked better, but I'm going to go back to mid. I think mid might look a little bit better. Now, it's up to you and where you live and everything on what setting you're going to use, but if you find it's too bright, go to mid. If it's still too bright, go to dark. Whatever suits you. Then you can rotate the rear camera. Now, the way I mounted my camera, you have a 50-50 chance of getting it right. So it's either going to be upside down or it's going to be right side up. And mine, I was wrong. So I hit enabled to rotate it. And now that enables me to see the camera correctly. Okay, now we're going to go to record settings. And I have a lot of this stuff enabled right now. And that's because I have it hardwired. So, like continuous parking, well, that's actually just for the super night vision. So it looks a little bit better at night. Parking mode. So because it's hardwired, I can now use parking mode. And I have it set to mid. So if something, I don't want a breeze to blow on the car and it starts recording. So I have it set to mid. I may change it to low later, but for right now it's mid. Everything's set to mid. And the battery protection is on because I don't want it to kill my battery. And let's see. Let's go back now to the road safety settings. Now this, I have all the stuff right here set. And what this does is it'll beep if you veer out of your lane. It's more, when you veer out of your lane, it's more of a clickety-clack sound. And at first I didn't know what the hell that was, but I figured it out later. And then if you get too close to cars, it beeps. I'm going to turn this off because I just don't find this part all that useful, but maybe for someone else it could be very useful. But I'm going to turn these things off. Another thing, though, if you're going to use this, you want to go to their site, Thinkware, and download the most current software for this, because I think this will be more up to date and work better if you keep that part of the software up to date. So I'm not going to bother with these things. I'm going to disable them and not use them anymore. So it's just not for me. So it's as easy as that. And let's go back again and go to system settings. So system settings, I have turned up all the way. Now you can turn her down a little bit. She's a little bit loud right now, so I turned her back to 2, which is default. And you get a lot of different languages that you can pick. Obviously, I have it on English. Now, if you don't want any sound at all, just put it to 0. But, you know, you're not going to hear any of those incident reports if you're hardwired and in parked mode. So I'm going to leave it either 1 or 2 because I don't really care to hear the intro that comes on every time I start the car. But it's not that bad. I'm getting used to it. You can turn on and off the LED on the rear camera. You can set your time zone, daylight saving time, miles per hour. I have mine set to miles per hour for the speed unit. Speed stamp is on. That means when you review the video back, you'll see your speed in miles per hour on the screen. And that could save you if you got pulled over by a cop that said you were speeding and you weren't. You can prove it right there. But then again, if you are speeding, you are going to shoot yourself in the leg when you show the video. So that's up to you if you want that on or not. Voice recording I have on. I like to, when I review the video, I like to be able to hear what's going on and what's being said. So that's on. And back, the last part, network settings or function. I don't have any of this thing enabled. I'm not planning to use it. I'm not even sure what all this stuff right here is, but it looks to me strong impact. It will send a message out if you get hit or something. So, but again, I'm not really worried about that part. I'm leaving that at default, which is all disabled, and that is kind of it. If you want to look at your footage, you go to File List, Continuous, and here's your footage right here. So you got your front camera, you got your rear camera. These are really short clips because it was just me starting and stopping, starting and stopping. I'll pick something that's a little bit longer maybe. I'm going to have to go down quite a bit because this was all during the install. So let's try something else here. And yeah, there we go. There's some driving. Now it's a little stuttery. It's not too bad though. I've seen a lot worse. These video clips will download pretty quick if you need to download them onto your phone. And well, that one's going really good right there. So that's the rear camera. Now I'm going to show you the software next, because on the software you can actually see front and rear really good, really smooth. It's really helpful. So. And again, if you want to just see the front, there's all your front views. Here's all your rear views. And back to all for front and rear. And let's see, continuous incident. There's nothing in there. Motion detection. This is like just what it said. If something's walking around up in front or out in the back, if it detects movement, it's going to film. Not sure what it was filming there, but it did catch me going in and out of the refrigerator in the garage, so that was cool. Parking incidents, so that was probably me just opening and closing the door. Manual recordings, I pushed the manual button a couple times on the dash cam. So if you want to make sure to get something, just press the big center button of the dash cam and that will manually start the record. And downloaded videos, these are videos that I've downloaded in the past. So here's the front. Look how smooth. Look how good that looks. That looks really good. That's the front camera. And there, here's the rear. That line is a heater line in the window, so it doesn't really hurt anything. So good picture there. And that is it for all your files. There's really not much else to show. If you don't want to be connected to your camera at all, just click on the connected via Wi-Fi at the bottom and press disconnect and she'll talk.
Disconnected from a smartphone.
And there you go.
Okay, so this dash cam will automatically put some files and folders on your SD card once you install it, or once you put it inside the dash cam. You'll get like continuous recording, which is all your files that you've filmed. This is a viewer for Mac. I think this is a viewer for Windows, but I don't have a Microsoft computer, so can't really tell. The user guide is here. There's a folder for parking, if something happens while you're parked, and so on. But I'm going to go into the dash cam viewer because I want you to see what that looks like. This is probably your best way of looking at the footage. So once that opens up, I'm going to open up the dash cam viewer here. Here it comes. Okay. Let's scroll down to something kind of current here. Let's try front camera, the F there for front. Double click it. Wait. And there we go. So I'm going to make this a little bit bigger. Okay, so that's what it looks like. Front camera in the middle, and off to the side is the rear camera and a map. Google, supplied by Google Maps. If you click on this little arrow here, right there, you'll flip the camera view and put the rear camera on the big screen, and your front's now on the small screen. So that's pretty good. I'm going to flip it back. You can see that you get information like your speed and everything down here. It might look a little small, but the bigger, you know, the more you stretch it out, the bigger all this gets. I'm going to pause this for a sec and show you. You can actually zoom in to see things like this sign right here. So go back to 1:1. Let's see. Let's go a little bit closer here. Let's play. Stop. Oh, did not mean to stop. Let's see if I can find that spot again. Okay, here we are. I'm going to hit play. I'm going to get right up to the end of the block here and zoom in. Simpson. So, okay. Right now, my setting is set to high. I put it back since then to medium. I think this is a little bit bright. But go ahead and hit play, and you can see it has your miles per hour, everything, your direction that you're going. So this is pretty cool, and pretty good software right here. If you need, you could take a screenshot of this and save it somewhere. I'm not going to save it. You could print it. Good software to have.
I'll put the driver's side down right now. Alright, the driver's side window is down now. I'll leave it down and I will put down the passenger side. See how much wind noise we get. Okay, let's get some nighttime footage.
go over some other parts that you can use if you want to hardwire this to your car. You may need a crimper, a wire tap, or a fuse tap, another fuse tap. And what you would do is you would take the fuse, you'd find a fuse in your car, in your dash, in your fuse box that is for accessory, and you would take the fuse out and you'd put this tap into that, where that fuse was, and then you'd put that fuse back in here, and then you'd put another fuse in for this. And let's say you were doing to the accessory first. Let's see, this one is accessory. So you've just simply put this in here after that and grab your crimper and crimp it down. So, and then you do the same thing with your battery side, then ground it, plug this into your camera, and you're all set, ready to go. So that's an easy way of installing it. It's really not hard. The other thing that you might want to get, and I'll put links to this or something like it, and like these on below the video. So these are little plastic pry tools that I use to get the cable underneath the rubber panels or any of the panels in the car by just shoving this under in between the panels, pulling back a little bit. Either side doesn't really matter. And tucking the cable in, sometimes pushing the cable in with a corner and dragging it down and getting the cable under that way. So again, I'll add links to all of these tools and parts in case you want. You don't have to have any of these, but if you would like to do it the way I did it, I'll put a list of the parts and where to get them below the video. So overall, my thoughts on this camera is very, very, very good. I like that it has a rear camera. Really like that. It has a front camera. The quality is 2K. I'll probably show you a clip or something like that where it shows, when I put it in my video editor, it even shows up as 2K. So it has 2K quality, which is pretty good. If you are filming and you need to get somebody's license plate and you have their license plate in the video, you may think to yourself, well, I can't see it. All you have to do is pause it, put it in a video editor, pause it, and crop that part, make it bigger, zoom in on it. You have enough data in the file that you get a pretty good zoom on it and get the license plate number off of it. Now that's the same with any dash cam. I don't care. I've used a lot, and all the dash cams, that's pretty much the same. I have needed to get license plate numbers before, and that's exactly what I did, as I put it the video in a video editor, and I zoomed in on it, and it was just as easy as that. So there's a lot of free editors out there for Windows and Mac. So but overall, love the camera. It's a keeper, and I'm going to end it right there. So take a look at the links below, and if you need any of the parts, they are linked to my Amazon store, so it helps me out and helps me continue doing these kind of reviews. So everything will be below the video, and I'll see you guys later. Thanks for watching.